Alright, welcome to R. In this video tutorial, I'm gonna briefly talk about R, what is R Studio, what are the advantages of learning R and R Studio, how we can install R or R Studio in our own laptop or our own PC. So R is one of the most popular and powerful programming language. It was developed in 1993 and was designed mainly for statistical analysis and computations. Some advantages of learning are, first, it's free. You don't have to pay anything, as opposed to other common statistical packages like SAS, SPSS, NCSS, and so forth. Second, it's open source, meaning that the codes are publicly available and you can modify and improve the original codes. It's interdisciplinary. R is widely used in numerous scientific disciplines. So far, more than 10,000 packages for a variety of purposes have been developed, such as in public health, ecology, biology, finance, marketing, and a lot more. And the number of packages and also the fields that use these packages are increasing every day. And some packages target very specific topics. You can use R to produce high quality graphs. We will see that in the future labs. And more importantly, the results of R can be reproducible, meaning that other people can generate the same result through the script. R also has a great community support in case you need the help of other people in running some codes. In this class, we will just apply basics of R for better understanding the material taught in the lecture. As I just mentioned, R is freely available for us and runs on all platforms such as Windows, Mac, and Linux. So you can easily download and install R on your own laptop or PC. Let's see how we can download and install R. The installation process is pretty straightforward. So to download R, you should go to r-project.org. r-project.org. In this page, you have to select CRAN. And CRAN stands for Comprehensive R Archive Network, which is main repository for R packages. So let's go ahead and select CRAN. And this page is about CRAN mirrors. And you should pick a mirror which is the nearest location to you. So the nearest location where you download R. So maybe it's different for you depending on the location that you are right now. But for me, it's in the United States and in Cleveland. So the nearest location to me is Case Western Reserve University in Cleveland, Ohio. So let's go ahead and select this one. So just select the location that is closest to you. As you can see, R runs on all platforms. So if you are a Windows user, you should select Download R for Windows. So if you use Mac, you should download R for Mac. And for Linux users, they have to install and download and install R for Linux, this option. I am using Windows right now, so I select Download R for Windows. In this page, you have to select Install R for the first time. And finally, you have to select Download R 3.6.2 for Windows, or maybe latest version. So installing R will be very easy. So after you click on this, it will be downloaded. And after you download the R, installation process is very easy. You can just accept the default option and you can easily install R. And one of the advantages of R here is that it won't take up much memory space on your computer. If I select this one, then okay, next, next, next. So if you just select the default value, it can easily be done. Pretty easy, pretty straightforward. And then finish. You can find it, I think, here. So this is the environment of R. Also, the steps are similar for Mac users. If you go to the r-project.org, then select CRAN, select the CRAN mirrors that is closer to you, and then select R for Mac. Here you can download the latest release of R with PKG extension. And then after you download the R for Mac, just accept the default options to install R on your own Mac free of charge. RStudio is an add-on to R and is a user-friendly environment compared to R, which makes working with R much more easier. RStudio is an IDE or integrated development environment, which helps us in developing programs in R. However, programming language in both R and RStudio is similar. If you want to use RStudio, you should first install R. However, having RStudio is not a must, but it's highly recommended to work with RStudio. It makes your life much more easier. Again, you should first install R and then install RStudio, which is also free, open source for Mac, Windows, and Linux users. We can download RStudio from rstudio.com. In this page, under Products, select RStudio. Scroll down and then select RStudio Desktop. And then we want download RStudio Desktop, which is free of charge. Choosing your version, RStudio Desktop free, download, and then so we can see that here it's automatically detected the suitable RStudio for our current computer system. So let's go ahead and select download RStudio for Windows. Again, installing RStudio is not a big deal, so just accept the default values. So if I click RStudio, next, install. It takes a few minutes for installation. So after you're done with the installation, you can close this page, and then you can open R and RStudio. So here is R environment, and here is RStudio environment. So let's quickly compare these two environments. So you can see that RStudio is much more organized. So you have console here, you have you can write your script here, console, you have environment. You can import a data set from here. You can see the result of plots and also packages if you need help for the commands. And also there are so many menus here, right? Just compare it. But let's compare it with the R. You can see that we don't have these windows and also these options. There are very few options for the menus. So in general, RStudio is much more user-friendly and simpler to work and more organized. So in this class, we will work only with RStudio, okay? So, but we call this R. So when we say R, we actually mean RStudio, just for the sake of simplicity. So, see you next time.